Good evening, friends. I am Grandmaster Saptarshi Roy. Today I am here to show you some interesting games. And I'll tell you, I am very aggressive player from childhood, and from which games I learn all those ideas. These ideas I'll show you today. So this game is between Passov and Zamora. E4, E5, Knight F3, Knight C6, Bishop C4. White played Italian and black played Knight F6. So this is called two knight defense. Well, so opponent played Knight G5, and we all knows in this position the main move is D3, but Knight G5, I can tell you here, is the best move is D5 and E into D5. Black should react with Knight A5. Now you can ask me, why not Knight into D5 here? Because in this position, many people made a mistake. I saw they used to capture with Knight. So today I'll show you why this move is not correct. So Knight into D5, in this position, White should immediately react with Knight into F7. And when King F7, White will move King F3, King E6 and Knight C3. So here we can see Black King is in danger, and this D5 Knight is under pressure with pin with Bishop, and Knight is putting more pressure on D5. So now Black should react with Knight B4 attacking on C2 pawn. So White move A3, Knight into C2 check, King D1. Now we can see in this position, both the knights are under attack. So if Black defend his d5 knight, then White can capture c2 knight with king into c2, and this king will be under trouble, e6 king. So here, if Black can react with knight into a1, then knight into d5. So now we can see in this position, this king is under trouble. Why? Because knight can move to c7 or b6, there will be discover check. And if king moves d6, then Black will lose many things. So here opponent played king d6. And what do you think, how to react in this position? So Black can move in future like c6 and king c7. Black will try to escape his king immediately. So this is the game between Grandmaster Alexey Shirov and Kuzmin Grandmaster with Black. So Alexey Shirov played d4 and bishop e6, then rook e1. Why rook e1 in this position? I'll explain you. Because e5 pawn is under attack now, and White pieces are much more active than Black pieces, and both the kings are in the center, but black king is under pressure. And here immediately Black played b5, because if White moves bishop into b5, Black can capture bd5. So now White react with knight b4. His main idea is queen c6. If king moves e7, then rook into e5. So in such a game, we can learn how to punish your opponent in the opening. Like if opponent will play some dubious move like knight into d5. So I'll show you the end of this game. Like b into c4, queen c6 check, king e7 and bishop g5. Well, this is very important game in this line, and we saw how Alexey Shirov beat Grandmaster Kuzmin, and we also made many mistakes in the opening sometimes when you don't know. So I am showing you all this thing. So I hope in future we will not make the same mistake again. Okay, now what we can do is we can go back to the main game and we can see So knight a5, here main move is bishop b5. But in this situation, white choose d3, which is nowadays not so popular. Why d3 is not so popular, I'll tell you. But before that, I can tell you, if opponent plays bishop b5 in this position, then black can react with c6. If d into c6, b into c6, here white can move bishop a4, queen a f3, and bd3, many moves, and black can react with queen c7, and later for one pawn black can develop his pieces very fast, and he can do short castle and do lot of attack like knight d5 and f5. This should be your plan in this position. Now when opponent played d3, now look at this position. Here you black already sacrificed one pawn, and black should not capture knight into d5 immediately, because we know knight into f7, maybe it can work here also. So here black played h6, knight f3, and e4. Well, e4 is very interesting move in this position, and here after e4, white is a bit under trouble, because if he moves knight d4, and then black can react with maybe bishop c5. Well, in this position, queen e2, white played here knight into c4, b into c4, and bishop c5. So I just want to ask you, why bishop c5 he played? Why not bd6 or bishop e7? Well, in this kind of structure, when black played bishop c5, his idea is to controlling the f2 to g1 to a7 diagonal and preventing knight d4 moves. Okay, in this kind of position, black can also sacrifice his e4 pawn for more well-developed pieces, like he can play short castle also in future. So here knight fd2, and black move bishop g4. Okay, so here if white wish he can play f3, but in this game white played queen f1. So just think about 2 minutes or 5 minutes, pause your video and just think in this position how black will react after f3. So here black move bishop f5, then if f into e4, and we can see short castle. Look at this position. Here after short castle, there is many threats like knight into e4, knight into e4, bishop into e4, if queen into e4, then rook e8. White will lose his queen immediately. And white pieces are underdeveloped, white king is in the center, so black sacrificed two pawn for so much well-developed pieces and lot of attack he got. So in this position, we can think if opponent, what opponent will react if he opponent will play if knight into e4, knight into e4, f into e4. So here black should choose queen h4 move, if g3, then queen into e4. Well, we all know we should not exchange our queen when we are material down, but in some position we can exchange where we have good developments, we can do castle immediately, and we can get our material back after exchange of queen, and we have pair of bishops. So in this position, black is having three pawn in the king side, when white is having two pawns. So pawn majority is there, but after queen into e4, bishop into e4, rook f1 short castle. So after this position, here black can react with rook fe8, rook a d8 and c6. So we can see here white can't escape his king immediately if he wish also. If he develop his pieces also, black can immediately react with bishop into c2, and then rook e8, rook a d8 and c6 will come. So all over black is clearly better, which I feel, and I like this position. I hope you all understand and you can handle such position easily after seeing this game. So we can get back with the main position, queen f1. Here black moved short castle, now h3. Well, in this position black played bishop h5. So here I can tell you bishop h5 is much more stronger than bishop f5, because previous position opponent played f3, so we played bishop f5 to exchange all the pieces and later to play queen h4. But here black want to prevent opponent castle, so bishop h5, and later if he moves like g4 and all, maybe sacrifice is possible if it's required. It depends on opponent's move and position. So knight b3, bishop e7, very strange move. And okay, just you can think about why bishop e7. So pause your video, think for 3 to 5 minutes, and then check why opponent played bishop e7. Well, I can explain you why bishop e7 is the correct move in this position. Black want to keep his bishop on b7, because later black want to keep his bishop to h4. Why h4? To controlling the h4 to e1 diagonal, to put more pressure opponent king, and also f2 is weak, and later he can sacrifice some pawn with e3 and all if it's possible. So bishop e7, bishop e3, and in this position if black will play some normal moves like bishop g7 or maybe rook e8, or white can immediately react with knight c3, and later he will of course try to play g4 and to do long castle, then black white position will be very good. So here is the main position where you can put more punishment to your opponent. How to give punishment to your opponent? Like I'll tell you, in this position is b5 is the correct move. Why b5? Just you have to destroy your opponent's center immediately. So now this is the correct time where you can destroy. So c4 pawn is controlling d5 pawn, preventing all threats. So if you can break this c4 pawn strength, so your pieces will come to the center and you can destroy your opponent king center with knight into d5 and knight into e3, and many pieces will come from bishop h4, queen g5, rook e8 and rook d8. So b5, immediately opponent react to g4, and this is the one more important position. Here also you can pause your video and think for 2-3 seconds, and you can choose between bishop g6 and bishop g4 and b into c4, which one is correct. You feel, you can check. So I hope you all got the correct move. Here b into c4 is the correct move. And okay, if opponent will capture g into h5, you can capture c into b3, a into b3 and knight into d5. So after g into h5, c into b3, a into b3 and knight into d5, here black can immediately react with knight into e3 and bishop into bishop h4 check, and then black white will be under pressure, and king e2, and then maybe queen g5, black can win this game very easily. So here opponent played queen into c4, and now one more very important and interesting move played by Zamora. And for this move only, I think he won this game very easily. So here also, if you wish, you can pause this video and you can think for 5 minutes. Well, in this position, black played knight into d5 and sacrifices bishop. And why knight into d5 in this position, I'll explain you. Here, knight into d5, g into h5, and knight into e3. So, black should exchange the knight with the bishop on e3, and should put his dark color bishop immediately h4 to destroy opponent castle king. So, here, if we capture g into h5, the knight into e3, f into e3, bishop h4 check, which I told you, king e2, and queen g5. So now there is a lot of threat, like queen g2, black is getting rook, queen into h5, white king is under trouble, under pressure. And according to computer, in this position, I'll tell you, king d1 is the best move. Well, if white moves king d1, black can immediately react with rook a d8, knight 1 d2, and bishop f2. So after bishop f2, we can see like black is getting bishop into e3 and can put lot of pressure on d2. White king is still under trouble, and later black can react with rook f8. He can move his king and played f5 also. So such position is very difficult to handle with white piece, and black can play very easily, and black can put more lot of pressure, and black can win very easily, I can assure you. So here king d1, instead of king d1, opponent played queen into e4. So black played rook e8. Now white move queen f3. White thought maybe in this position he can develop his knight and he can bring his rook. After knight c3 on knight d2, he can move his rook on g1, and somehow he will be successful to escape his king from d1, c1 and b1. So friends, this is one more position where you can think for 5 minutes or 10 minutes as much as you can until you find winning, and you can check how black react in this position. Well, I feel you all got found this move easily. And here opponent played rook into e3, which is double exclamation. Well, I'll explain to you why black played rook into e3. So as we saw, that knight c3 and rook g1 was white idea. So here rook into e3, queen into e3, queen g2, and okay, if he moves king d1, black can immediately react with queen into h1, and again king e2, queen g2, and later rook d8 check. So white played king d3 and rook d8. So after rook d8, we can see white king is under trouble. So why? Because he can move to c4 and c3. So suppose king c3, if black moves, then black and white moves, then black can react with bishop f6. And we can see here he couldn't develop his pieces like rook a1 and rook h1 and knight b1, but king is roaming here there. So this is very funny for me. I hope you all are enjoying to see this. And well, here opponent played king b4, if then queen b7 check, king a5 and rook d5. See, in such position where in the middle game in 26 moves king should be on a5 a1 instead of a5, where white king is roaming on a5. So this is the way where you can put lot of pressure and bring your opponent king to the center. So black can react like such way and black can win his game. So here opponent react king c4 instead of king c3, queen d5 check, king b4, rook b8 check, king a3. And maybe here also many best moves are there. You can pause your video and think for a couple of minutes and you can check. Well, excellent move played by Zamora, bishop e7 check. Why bishop e7 check? Why black is sacrificing one more piece? Because if you capture queen into e7, rook into b3, one more excellent rook sacrifice, and if captured, then queen a5 mate. So such position can possible if you can bring your opponent king to the center in the middle game. And you can see in this game where black sacrificed two rook, one minor piece like knight, to mate white king. So that's why I like this game. I hope all viewers love this game, and from this game I learned many things in my life. I wish you all can learn many of things from this game. I'll catch you in the next class. Thank you.